Good morning. I'd like to just bring you up to speed with regards to the investigation that you're all aware of with regards to Project Corral that took place on Tuesday the 4th of May. And I can indicate being a part of the investigation that on Tuesday the 4th of May at approximately 5 a.m., the quality of life in a number of communities within the City of Toronto and the Greater Toronto Area were instantly improved by the arrest that took place at 5 o'clock in the morning. I can honestly say that from doing this type of work for the last 14 years. The Homicide Squad has been working with the Organized Crime Enforcement Unit on an ongoing basis with regards to the murders of Aeon Grant and Tyrell Duffus. As a result of the raids that took place Tuesday, the Toronto Police and our policing partners have tangibly demonstrated our ongoing efforts with regards to community safety in these particular communities. On Tuesday, my partner, Detective Chris Neal, and I had the opportunity to spend the majority of the day interviewing the Falstaff Crips following their arrest. And I can tell you from those hours of interactions with these individuals that they offer nothing to the community in a positive way, and that the atmosphere of fear is created by the criminal activity that was being conducted in those particular areas. And I'll center my attention with regards to the Falstaff area. It's the hope and the desire of the Toronto Police Service that as a result of the arrests, that members of the community now feel safer and more able to come forward with information pertaining to these two particular murders. And that is our hope, and that is truly our desire. And we, the police, absolutely need the community's help to solve these two particular cases. If those individuals come forward, I assure you that we will address any and all of their security concerns to their absolute satisfaction. I just want to speak briefly about the individuals within the Falstaff apartment buildings, just for a moment, who assist, support, and enable these gangsters to conduct their criminal activities. The individuals who are doing this, I'm sure they are aware of who they are. It's now time for you to choose what side you're on. Loyalty to these criminals and the criminal element within these buildings are likely going to involve yourself in criminal activity, and you will ultimately face the same type of consequences that took place on Tuesday, the 4th of May. The officers within 31 Division were working hard with the community, Toronto Community Housing Authorities within the Falstaff area to improve the quality of life for the residents, and that those efforts are continuing. I can say specifically with regards to Aeon Grant's investigation is that Aeon Grant and his friends were shot on the 3rd of December, late in the evening, just before midnight, as they were walking through the stairwell heading up in the 30 building, the middle building of the three. They were heading to an apartment on the 15th floor that they had been frequenting for a number of weeks. The deceased and the others were from the Rexdale area, and then clearly that is been determined to be a motive with regards to Rexdale guys being in the Falstaff area, and obviously it resulted in the shooting of Mr. Grant and his friends. In an effort to generate additional witnesses, the Chief of Police, Chief Blair, has authorized a reward of $50,000 for information leading to the arrest and convictions of the individual or individuals responsible for Aeon Grant's murder. Once again, just briefly in conclusion, and there'll be an opportunity to ask some questions at the end, is that the commitment to community safety is a shared responsibility, and as I indicated to deceased Aeon Grant's family, is that without the community, the Toronto Police, and more specifically in these cases the Homicide Squad, are not going to be successful. And our desire is that as a result of the arrests, that we definitely have tangibly shown our efforts and commitment to community safety, and it's at this time now that we would like members of the community to come forward. As I indicated to you, any and all of your security concerns with regards to coming forward and giving information to the police would be addressed to your satisfaction. I'm going to ask Pauline Sawyers to make some comments about the murder of her son, and then Detective Carboni will make comments as well.